Okay, so this is joint C. I'm sure that this is 13 42 and this is an unknown force FEC, and this is also collinear to this force. This is also unknown, and this is FCB. I should know an angle. In fact, I know that this is 26.6, then this means that this is 26.6, and this is also 26.6. Okay? So guys, let's apply the two equations of equilibrium. Sum of x is equal to 0, give me what? Will give me minus FEC plus 13 42 cosine 26.6 plus FCB cosine 26.6, and this is equal to 0. Now sum of y is equal to 0 will give me what? Will give me minus 13 42 sine 26.6 minus FCB sine 26.6 is equal to 0. And this will give me what? And this basically will give me that FCB will be equal to minus 13 42 newton. And if I substitute this FCB here, I can find FEC, and basically look what I find. If this is minus 1342 here, so this is minus 1342 here, then I can simplify all this term with this term, then FEC will be equal to 0. So this is equal to 0, and FCB is negative, which means it should be in this direction right here. Now guys, I can know basically that this force here in EC will be equal to 0. How? By doing a rotation for X and Y. So basically, if I take this Y and then the perpendicular to this, which is X, okay? So if I take this reference, for each joint, guys, you can take any reference, okay? What matters is that these two axes should be perpendicular, okay? Now, if I take this Y here in the same direction as the line CB, which means in the same direction as this force and this force. So these two forces are basically collinear. So if I take this Y here, and then what I want to do is the sum of forces around this x. So let's, guys, call this y prime and x prime, and let's do the sum of forces in x prime. I know that 1342 and FCB, they are both along y prime, which means they do not have any projection on x prime. So the projection on x prime is 0. I only have the projection of what? Of FEC on x prime. This projection is equal to 0 because I know that the sum of x prime is equal to 0, which means FEC is equal to 0. So basically, guys, since this projection on x prime is equal to 0, then FEC will be itself equal to 0, and I will explain this later on in the part of zero force member. In fact, guys, if I have two collinear forces, then the third force will be equal to 0. And this is in the case of no other external force. So if I have only three forces on the joint, two of them are collinear, the third one will be equal to 0. Okay? So that's why FEC is equal to 0. Okay? So since FEC is equal to 0, then this force here from E to C will also be equal to 0, as if this member, guys, does not exist because the force inside it is equal to 0. Okay? So as if this member doesn't exist. Now, I still have B and A. Basically, guys, I know that the force FCB is equal to 1342, then I can know that this is also 1342. And then, guys, can I do B? Basically, no, because I have 1, 2, 3 unknowns. So let's do basically A. Or before A, let's do E. Okay? So let's take E. Now, what about E? I know that this force is 0, and I only have 2 unknowns. Okay? So, and I know basically, guys, that these two forces are collinear. Okay, so DE and EA, these two forces are collinear. However, I cannot say that the force inside EB is zero because I have an external force here that is equal to minus 100 newton. So let's do joint E. Okay, so this is E. This is the 900 newton, an external force. I know that this force is equal to 1200. I will assume that this force, which is FEA, is out. And I will assume that FEB is also out. Okay? And of course, since this is 2, and this is 2, and this is a right triangle, and of course, this will be 45. There's no need to put EC because the force inside is equal to zero. So let's do this. Guys, remember, I cannot say that FEB is equal to zero because in fact I have another fourth force. Okay? So if 900 newton doesn't exist, I have two collinear forces, then of course this FEB will be equal to zero. Now here I have 100 newton, so I cannot say this. Let's apply sum of Fx is equal to zero. And sum of Fy is equal to zero. Okay? So I will start by sum of Fy is equal to zero. Sum of I will start by sum of Fx is equal to zero. So 900 plus Feb cosine 45 cosine 45, this is the same, is equal to minus 1272 newton. So it is negative, I should flip it. I will not flip it now. Basically, guys, you flip it once you finish all your analysis. So you will continue sum of F5 with the same direction of FEB, which is negative, okay? Now, sum of F5 is equal to zero. It gives me that 1200 minus FEA minus FEB cosine 45 is equal to zero. And now this means that FEA is equal to 2100 newton, and it is positive, which means that this is correct, the direction of this force is correct, and this should be in this direction. So I can now paste them here. So FEB will be it will be into E, and it is equal to 1272, and FEA will be out from E because it is positive and it is equal to 2100. So now, guys, I can basically do B because in fact this 1272 will be opposite to B, so this will be 1272, and then I can take this B to find the reactions. And this is also, guys, you can skip this part because the question is only to find the internal forces. So I don't have to find the reactions. And now for A, I know that this should be opposite, which means that this should be upward and is equal to 2100. And then you can take A to find the reactions, but here, guys, there is no need to take A because in fact the question is only to find the internal forces. Now what about compression or tension? You can take D and DC. D and DC is subjected to compression, then DC is in compression. D in DE is subjected to tension, then DE tension. E in EC is subjected to zero force, so EC is not neither in tension nor in compression. E in EA is subjected to tension, then EA is subjected to tension. Is subjected to compression, then EB is subjected to compression. C in CB is subjected to compression, then CB to compression. Okay, so that's how you can predict if the members are in tension or in compression. And for the last time, I want to say this, guys. If D is in compression in the member DC, then DC should be in compression. So guys, don't get confused because this figure, okay? So because this figure, you can say that the forces are in tension as shown in this figure, then DC should be in tension. No, guys, these forces are the forces exerted on the joints. So if you have to draw the forces exerted on the member, you should flip them. So this will be the force exerted on the member. And these forces are in compression. Okay, guys, so don't get confused. D is in compression in DC, then DC is directly in compression. Okay?